Hey, Blake Ritter here. Today, I'm going to talk about video editing. Now, video content creation is becoming a trend because it retains the human attention much longer than words and images. And for a beginner filmmaker, it's often really difficult to find the software that's free to use. Now, I'm going to show you today an editing software called Filmora from Wondershare. I'm going to go over its features and effects and just to show you that how easy actually it is to use. And by the way, if you want to try this software while watching the video, there's a link in the description where you can download. Okay, let's jump right in. So if you are a very new editor, this might be a lot to kind of take in. And if you have used other program before, this is quite similar. There's a window here to preview what video you have, and this is a timeline which I'll show you in a bit. But for new people, it's pretty simple. You just go to your media or import and they'll come in this list here. You can simply drag or you can preview here first before you drag it. So you can drag different sections, which is pretty simple. Just click where you want to start and where you want to finish, and then you just drag here. And the other thing I really like, which makes this different to most of the editors that I've used, is that sometimes you want to edit a small section, you have to zoom into it. And if you can see on the right here, you have to normally do that to make it bigger or smaller. But what's cool about this is all you have to do is just do that and go like that. It's so much easier than going all the way over there. I really like this feature. Cutting different clips into different small parts. Again, some of the editor, you have to have a short key. You have to know what that is. But this, again, it's right in front of you. You just click that, well, place it where you want it to be, the marker. So if you want to here, you just clip it, and now you have two. So that's kind of a basic editing features. Let's go into some of the more exciting features we have. First feature I want to talk about is the speed ramping, which is so cool. Very unique feature that I haven't seen anywhere else. So I have this clip, which is from an intro from one of my short film called a C600. Let me just play for you. It's very short for now. So just click here, baseball. As you can see, it's a very slow movement from here to kind of here. Now let's say I want the speed to increase here quickly and then slow down back to how it was before. For features of other editors, you have to something like cut one here and then cut one here, and then you change the speed to this one, and then eventually it's just a lot of work. But for Filmora, they have a speed ramping feature, like I said. So you right click on here, and then you go to speed and duration, and it will come up this screen. Then you go to speed ramping. You have different options here. You have ones that's built in for you, called montage, hero moment, bullet time, jumper, blah blah blah. So what that does, for example, hero moment, I think what that does is it speeds up, slows down, and speeds up and back to normal again. So whatever goes up is speed up, whatever goes down and speed down. We can try that, see how that looks, just to give you a kind of demonstration, but that's not exactly the effect I want. But if you were to choose hero moment, this is what it looks like. It's not bad, but obviously this is slowing down as well, which is not the footage is able to slow down. So you can go to customize. This is where the exciting things happen with the speed ramping. You can choose exactly what point you want it to speed up. So if you want to speed up around about here, you just move that here. You go speed 5 times, 10 times. So if I want to speed up really fast, go back to normal. I don't want it to go back to normal until the end, towards the end. So maybe about towards the middle, this should do. And then press, and if you press play from the beginning, as you can see, it speeds up at the beginning and then slows down at the end, which is really cool feature. Of course, you can go slower down. If you go lower, it slows down. Let's just say I want it to slow down about here. And that's it. So we go from the beginning, it slows down, and you can't really see much of a difference because it's already a slow clip. So if I were to go slow down and speed up, slow down, and it's gonna increase and back to normal. See how smooth that is? Because what it does, instead of jumping to a very fast speed, to a normal speed, it gradually increases and gradually decreases. That's why it's so smooth when it goes up and down. Okay, next feature is motion tracking. Now, maybe you've seen this before in videos where you see an object being tracked with some kind of text or some layer on top as it goes through the footage. So I have a short clip here from my short film, La Mana. Let's just quickly play this clip here. You see the car just drive from left to right. Now I want to put text above the car. So what to do? First, I want to track the motion of the car. You want to move the marker all the way to the beginning or wherever from the point you want to track it to start. Anything before won't be tracked. So I want to track from the very beginning. I go from there. And then double click on the track, and you can see all the different options here. So I go to motion tracking, switch on, you get a little box that comes up, you double click on that, and then you can size it to roughly the same size of the object that you need to tracking. So this, in this case, it's a car, place on the car and start tracking, and it will do its magic. There you go. And then now to put the text, so I come out of here, I go to titles, and I just want a plain text for this tracking. I drag down the plain text to the timeline, have the same length of the track, and then double click on here so I can change the text to what I want to say. I wanted to say car. Don't worry where the position of the letters are for now. You exit that. And then double click here, going back to the tracking area. Now you see there's a drop down, and basic six is the basic six, as you can see here where the title is. So you select, that's where you want the track to be on. And it goes right on top of the car, but that's not the right position. So what I wanna do, I wanna double click that. I wanna move it to the top and maybe a little bit smaller. You can do all those adjustments. Once you're happy, then just press play. How cool is that? And there you go. Hope you've enjoyed a quick overview of Filmora. Like I said before, there's a link in the description below if you want to try out the software yourself. Any comments or questions, please let me know, and see you next time.